EA Sports, within the game. Hey, they say it ain't over till it's over, and let me tell you, this one definitely ain't over.
We spent your whole life trying to blow up, but Elohim never had time for donuts. The beat go ham, no time for cold cuts. The game like Big Fish came to Jonah. Yeah, I'm still independent, ain't sold a million records, yeah. Used to be on my checklist, big diamonds don't need a necklace. Look, we built the sound like it's double speed Tetris. I cannot build without God in it. We built the sound, you can't copy this. I never brag, it's just confidence. I never rap for your compliments. I wrote this one for the indie grind. If you ain't signed on the dotted line, can't buy my soul with no dollar signs. The industry so full of troglodytes. I don't follow trends. Say that with my chest. Run it up. No, I will not bend. Run it up. Gang time in it. Gang time. I don't follow trends. Gang time. Say that with my chest. Gang time in it. Gang time. I will not bend. Gang time in it. Gang time. Run it up. 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 You gotta put in that work, dog. I put the kingdom first. I know that you gotta wait for your turn sometimes to build something really sustainable. Work on your catalog. So the day that you finally pop off, you'll see it's not just a once off. You put in time, the harvest is ready, it's ripe. I thank God for the payment. That's a solid foundation. When I finally make it, I give God all the praises. G.O.D. who conquered evil forces. I don't trust in chariots or fortresses. Yeah, I walk by faith. I don't follow trends. Run it up. Say that with my chest. Run it up. No, I will not bend. Run it up. Gang time in it. Gang time. I don't follow trends. Gang time. Say that with my chest. Gang time. I will not bend. Gang time. Run it up. Run it up.
Make major moves, still the same ones that I came with. Up in a payment, told you we nothing to play with. Guess some things unchangeable. Me and my thirst insatiable. Tell you all big time, face on my rollie on big time. Face of my goals, that's a big climb. Still my floor is unshakable. Run it up, I cannot quit it. I need it, I ain't where I wanna be.
It's the NFL on EA Sports, and we are at Highmark Stadium in upstate New York. Today we're set for a good AFC matchup between the Kansas City Chiefs and the Buffalo Bills. are underway in Buffalo. From his end zone, Isaiah McKenzie. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. Cook as they begin on the ground. And good yardage as he gets this one up to about the 23. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three. You often say that sort of opens the playbook now, second and short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
So they'll come up after the gain of seven on a second and three. Allen now looks to throw. All that gets him is just a yard, and now it's third down. Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first. Allen going to try and throw on third down. Isaiah McKenzie hauling it in. And he is going to have a Bills first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Their first possession of the game, and they're already going after double coverage.
That's a nice completion that can set the tone for things to come if they're able to keep finding ways to beat what the defense is throwing at them. They look like they're confident that they can get it done.
Here's Allen on first and 10. He's got the hookup with Diggs. And all the way home for a Bills touchdown.
For as big and strong as some of these guys are, especially when you see them in full pads, it is sometimes hard to appreciate how truly fast they can move. That was incredible.
An extra point by Bass, up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. Touchdown, Bass to kick it away. A fairly short kick from the 14. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29. Will lead the Chiefs up first and 10, just shy of the 30. Now the Georgia Southern man. This is Jerick McKinnon. And room to run as he's up past the 35-yard line. A good run, got seven on first. Here's second and three. Here's Mahomes. And that one going to be off target and incomplete. Travis Kelce, the Pro Bowl tight end, the intended target. And it's third and short.
Now you could have scanned downfield forever, but there wasn't anything available. Ends up throwing an incompletion, and I think he'll take that.
And now the Bills are going to stop it as they call a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Looks to throw on third down. This one complete to Mecole Hardman. And he will have a Chiefs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
First down, Chiefs.
McKinnon now going to try the left side. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
After the pickup of five, here's second and five. Accept the penalty, of course, and push the offense backwards a bit. So the delay of game penalty moves it back five. That makes it second and ten. Shotgun snap to Mahomes. He finds McKinnon.
Yo, you're fucking annoying, cuz. I hate you, bro.
And another first down.
We often talk about understanding the
but you can't do that.
Progressions and understanding what the defense is doing. We saw all of that on that play. Great recognition and understood where his running back was going to be. Found a way to have him leak out underneath, hit him with the football, and they picked up the first down.
On first down now, run with McKinnon.
Yo, why are you chewing clock and why are you keep doing meta plays? You're chewing clock and doing meta plays. Yo, you're chewing clock and you're doing meta plays. You're chewing clock and doing meta plays. Why?
You go through your offensive script, you go through your play calling, you go through all
this stuff. Oh man, this nigga right here, bro. This nigga right here chewing clock and then doing meta plays.
After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. First down, McKinnon again. And he'll get this one down to about the 17. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and nine.
And this is why aggressive defense coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D lineman to make the play.
On second and nine, Mahomes. Into the hands of Smith-Schuster on the crossing pattern. And the Chiefs are going to have a first and goal as the tackle is made at about the five.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
Straight ahead they go with McKinnon. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
That was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick. And what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
Second down and goal, Mahomes. And he'll just throw this one over in the way of the security crew. Incomplete here.
Excellent recognition that none of his receivers were beating coverage and getting open, so he just threw that one away. They'll come back to the huddle, reset, and try something different.
This has been a long drive. You got to figure a field goal would be a letdown. Can they convert now on third and goal? Throwing now is Mahomes. Trying to improvise. Under pressure now, and he's going to go down. Sack back around the 8. Ed Oliver, that time to want to get in there.
So you do all that, two clogs, do all that other stuff to kick the field goal.
And that's going to force him into a field goal attempt.
So on fourth down, Mahomes off, Harrison Butker on for the Chiefs field goal. Butker's kick here is good. Well, I don't know if they would have gone for it on fourth and goal anyway, but the sack on third down pretty much made their mind up for them.
You're exactly right about that, and this is a tough place on the field to take a sack because, as you just noted, it took the decision-making away from them. Now they have to go for a field goal instead of potentially going for it.
McKenzie now from his end zone. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15.
For most people, the excitement of a kickoff return is to see a long one that goes back in the opposite direction. But for the guys covering it, it's being able to stop them deep in their own territory. How about that incredible form tackle right there? Shoulder into ball carrier, and down he goes.
Buffalo offense ready to go for their next drive.
Well, certainly they'd rather have the scenario they had last time out, Charles. Remember, they had the short field. They took it in the end zone. Now this is going to have to be a longer, more sustained drive if they want to get points.
Yeah, a little bit more of a quick strike opportunity last time by where they were on the field, and you're exactly right about that. But now, backed up a little bit, was that old expression we love to use? Time to matriculate the ball down the field and try and do it again.
2 minutes to play in this first half, 7-3, our score. Allen now on first down. And Diggs has it. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. And meanwhile, Allen's throw taken in by Diggs. He's got this to the 30 before being taken down. Throwing on first down is Allen. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. The Chiefs will use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Now Allen again. Buying time to his left. And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down.
This is where good coaching and execution come into play, because down this close, you absolutely don't want to turn it over. Good job keeping that in mind as he escaped, bought time, and decided throwing it away was his best option.
On second and goal, Allen. And he's got it. They get only a yard there. Now it's third and goal. Now a second timeout called for by the defense, as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. This is third and goal. This Chiefs defense, they're giving it all they got. Again, they'll throw with Allen. And this is caught for a Bills touchdown. James Cook, a 2-yard touchdown grab. And the Bills will extend their lead in the final minute of the half.
Gardner, to me, that touchdown had something that was kind of rooted in that group seeing the future. What I mean by that is they had a plan. Let's find a way to score right here before the half. And that'll give us momentum going into the second half. Give us that cushion that we're looking for. They got that accomplished, scoring right before the half ended.
Extra point by Bass, up and good. And that pushes the lead up to 11. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. Pulls it in at the 13. And he takes this near the 25. Just a little pass there. Call it the 26. Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And Charles, you're down multiple scores, less than a minute left here, but with that deficit, they've got to try to at least work their way into field goal range to try to muster something out of this drive.
And I'm going to go ahead and date myself one more time because I'm going to quote an old Smokey and the Bandit lyric. They've got a long way to go and a short time to get there, but they still have time to get it done. So I'm looking forward to watching them mount this drive and see if they can get some points out of it.
And he'll be taken down, but not before they reach the 50. The Chiefs quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one. First and 10 here. And, you know, if they could just get three out of this, something about whittling it to a one-score game at half that might provide a psychological boost. From midfield, here's Mahomes. Eluding the pressure right. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
Throwing again on second and 10. Mahomes. A quick throw there, going to be batted away and incomplete.
Nice back-to-back plays defensively. They're stacking momentum now. One incompletion, two incompletion. They're going for more.
Mahomes to throw once more. And he comes back with one complete. And he'll only get this to about the 44 as they stop him short of the line to gain. Mahomes gonna go on fourth down.
Yeah, yeah, we're not doing that no more, but you about, yo, you pissed me off, bro.
The Chiefs tried it, but they're turned away on fourth down. And the Bills are going to get the football back. Well, it was too far for a field goal try. You don't really gain a whole lot out of a punt, so I don't think you have much of a problem with that, do you?
No, not at all. I think it's the right play, the exact right play, because even if you want to play defense and pin them deep, you know how hard it is for a punter to knock one dead inside the 10-yard line. That's not necessarily easily done. So I think going for it there was the right call.
Oh, now your network messing up, huh? Oh, now your network messing up now, huh? Yup, always happens. Always happens, yup, and he kicks out.